بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، معاكم مرة تانية دكتور سيد الخولي. بنتكلم عن الكورس of materials management for the second grade English section. Now we are going to talk about chapter number 6, which is just in time purchasing, which we call it as lean purchasing. As introduction for this chapter, just in time purchasing system that's developed by Japanese long time ago, which is the main concept of this just-in-time system, is to reduce the lead time. What is the lead time? It is the time between placing an order until you receive it. So as we discussed in the previous chapter, chapter 5, with economic order quantity, the more we reduce the cycle time, more orders over years is better for the system in order to meet any customer change. So it helps us with flexibility issue. There is many advantage we are going to talk about for applying just-in-time system. It is also, we call it as a Japanese management system or purchasing system, which it allow strategic alliance or strategic partnership between the supplier and the manufacturer. Is to be able to, philosophy is based on two things, the trust between the supplier and manufacturing, and high commitment between supplier and purchasing system. It reduces many aspects such as the paperwork and all of that, which is reduced ordering cost and holding cost, and it is reflected in total cost of the product they produce. Let's see what we have here, and then we'll discuss it one slide at a time. Just-in-time, which sometimes you call it lean purchasing, just-in-time production control system, focus in reducing both raw materials and work in process inventory. So the smaller the order, the better the system will be. Just-in-time require the right material are provided to workstation at the right time. And that is the definition of just-in-time. So we receive the material on time in order to keep the process running. It's a philosophy of trust and the commitment of the entire organization. So in order to apply a just-in-time system, you must have this philosophy, which is built on trust and strong commitment between the supplier and the manufacturer. And not only for one department, but for all for the entire organization. The major benefit of implementing just-in-time system impact the entity involved in supply chain management. It is part of the supply chain management. So the major characteristic of just-in-time purchasing is reduce order quantity. As we mentioned before, the smaller the order quantity, the better the system will be. Frequent and on-time delivery schedule. It has to be on time. By the time we reach zero level of quantity, we assume the new order will arrive on time, so the process will be continued. Reduce lead time, so the shorter the lead time, as we mentioned before, the better the system will be. So the basic objective of just-in-time purchasing is to reduce or minimize the lead time. The lead time, again, it is the time between placing an order until you receive it. So the more we reduce the lead time, the better the system will be. High quality of incoming materials. So we transfer all the quality perspective, the specifications, the standard, and so on. We transfer it from the manufacturer to the supplier. So we are not going to use any supplier does not commit himself from producing high quality of materials or raw materials or component parts. So we transfer all the quality issue from the manufacturer to the supplier. So we are not going to receive the inputs of the system. As we mentioned before, any system, it's inputs, process, and output. So we transfer all the specification, all the standard to the supplier. We are not going to accept any part or component part or materials unless it satisfies high standard of quality. Of course, we need a reliable supplier. A reliable supplier is to provide us with the high quality, and it has to be on time at the same time. That is the major characteristic of just-in-time purchasing. let's see how this kind of advantage will take it one by one. Reduced order quantity, where the relationship between supplier and buyer in just in time allow the ordering cost to be reduced. We minimize the ordering cost to simplify the negotiation and transportation cost. As you see in this graph, we have the reduction in order cost. It goes through about six processes. It started with negotiation, open order status per paperwork, expanding, receiving, count, receiving, and inspection in transportation. That is the traditional approach which we have in any system. The just-in-time system reduces these six processes into only two processes. Start with negotiation until transportation. So in, there is four function here, which is open order status, paperwork, expanding, receiving count, receiving, inspection. This eliminated in just-in-time system. So it reduced these six processes into only two processes in just-in-time approach, which is negotiation and transportation. A substantial decrease in the ordering cost permit a greater number of order to be placed over shorter interval. So instead of dealing with six processes, now we have only two processes, which is the starting one in negotiation with the between the manufacturer and the supplier, and transportation is to transport the materials, whether it's raw materials or component parts, to the inputs of the system, which will reduce it. Instead of six processes, now for just in time, it is two, only two processes. So it saves time, it saves money, it saves ordering costs, and so on. That is the first one. Frequent and on-time delivery schedule. In order to obtain a small lot size for production, the order quantity size needs to be reduced, and the corresponding delivery schedule needs to be made more frequent. Delivery window is very narrow. Let's see the difference between the reduced lead time, which in the traditional approach, we have paperwork lead time, manufacturing lead time, transportation lead time, and receiving and inspection. That is the traditional approach for reduction in lead time, which we have four processes. It's eliminated in just-in-time system to be only two processes, which is manufacturing lead time and transportation lead time. So we save here about 50% of the total process, which it was before in traditional approach. Now in just-in-time is only two processes. So to be able to maintain low inventory level, it is critical that replenishment lead time be as short as possible. So the more we reduce the lead time, the better the system will be. Reducing the lead time, it has many advantages, because if we have a large quantity in the process, work in process, our inventory in process, our in-process inventory, it means we are not going to be able to meet the customer chain, because we have large quantity of materials or component part inside the system. So we have to get rid of that, and this takes a long time. So we're not going to be able to meet the customer a change, which is frequent change right now with new technology. we'll go back again to the advantage of just-in-time version, high quality of incoming materials. So in just-in-time version play a very critical role in improving product quality at the manufacturing source, inspection at the supplier factory. Instead of doing the inspection by the manufacturer, no, we transfer all this inspection process to the supplier. So we are not done to accept any part or component part or raw materials from supplier unless it meets our quality specification. That is cost reduction. Reliable supplier just-in-time promotes the concept of fewer but better a supplier. For instance, Ford Motor Company, during the 80s, they reduced their supplier by about 40%. So instead of having 100 suppliers, they reduce it to only 40 suppliers. So reliable supplier, it means we rely in a few suppliers who are committed, and we have trust between the manufacturer and the supplier in order to meet our requirement. That is very important aspect. So it's a culture concept, you know, here. Culture concept where trust and strong commitment, that is part of success of just-in-time system. As we are going to see the culture effect for using just-in-time system. It's a behavior, it's a philosophy, which we focus on trust and strong commitment from all different level in the organization, whether in the manufacturing and in the supply. So we must have a trust between these two sides, and we have to have a strong commitment. So reliable supplier, it meets our supply, it meets our standard, it meets our quality, it meets our price, it meets the delivery or service from both sides, from manufacturing and from the supply. Here we have a major comparison between traditional just-in-time system and just-in-time lean purchasing approach. For order quantity, the traditional purchasing based on trade-off between ordering and carrying cost. In just-in-time purchasing, based on a small lot size for production. So instead of buying large quantity, we buy a small quantity. Delivery schedule. This being infrequent primarily because of high ordering costs involved. Frequent. For just-in-time, it's frequent because of small lot size and low ordering cost. Delivery window relatively wide, very narrow. The lead time is very long in traditional system. In just-in-time, is very short. Delivery lead time relatively long and relaxed, stringent and reduced significantly in just-in-time. Parts quality, responsibility of the quality function in the organization, no, in just in time, we'll transfer all of that to supplier. So the responsibility, it's on the supplier to meet all the quality specification we require. Supplier base, fairly broad, considerably smaller in just in time purchasing system. So that's very important, this comparison between the traditional approach and just in time approach. And as we showed to you in the last two graphs, it reduced by 60%, it reduced by 50%, and so on. Purchasing benefit, reduced inventory level from, for example, here Toyota is one of the people who first applied the just-in-time concept, have been able to speed up its inventory turnover 6 times per year compared to corresponding ratio of 5 to 8 to reported by American manufacturer. That's comparison between American manufacturer and Japanese manufacturer. Japanese manufacturer in Toyota, they order time, turnover of inventory, it's 6 times per year. In American manufacturing, it's 5 to 8 order per year. So here is a smaller quantity. Here is a huge quantity or greater quantity versus small quantity to order. And that is the significant difference, and that is the reason for the success of Japanese manufacturing system during the late 70s and 80s, where reducing a number of orders or increasing the number of orders per year with small lot, it give them advantage of lowering the lower cost. When you lower the ordering cost, you lower the total cost and reflect it on the price of the product they sell. Improved lead time reliability, this implies higher level of customer service and lower safety stock. When you improve the lead time, minimize the lead time, it means you will be able to meet the customer change. And in today's market, the customer in a constant change. What we use yesterday is not the same what we use today. So the customer in a constant change. In order to keep the speed with the customer change, we should order in a small quantity, not in a large quantity. The third one, benefit from purchasing perspective, is scheduling flexibility. This prevents confusion of the manufacturing plan and offer unique competitive advantage to manufacturing firms, since they are capable of adapting to change in the environment more quickly. And that is the flexibility issue. Flexibility, it means constant change for the environment, from the customer, from any technological change, so we are able to deal with. And basically, the traditional system, it used to be a push system. In just-in-time, it is a pull system. Improved quality and the customer satisfaction. High quality incoming material result in saving associated with reduced work and scrap cost. And that is very important issue for the quality and the customer satisfaction. The more quality you have, the more the customer will be satisfied. The less quality you have, the more the customer will be dissatisfied. and dissatisfied customer, it hurt the manufacturer where they can turn to another competitor, to another manufacturer, and so on. So they will lose their business in the long run. Reduced cost of part, relationship between supplier and manufacturer lead to conduct an extended value analysis and focus on reducing the cost of part and version. Dealing with a fewer supplier, it means the more we are successful as a manufacturer, the more the success will be for the supplier at the same time. So that's what we call it as a strategic partnership between the manufacturing and the supplier. So it is win-win strategy. Win-win strategy means the supplier win, and at the same time, the supplier win. The more the manufacturing grows, the more the supplier will grow. And for example, Toyota Motor Company, they produce 100 cars, so they need for the tire 500 tires. So if Toyota grow, they produce instead of 100, 1,000 cars, so they need 5,000 tires. If they produce 1 million cars, it means they need 5 million tires. So Toyota grow at the same time, supplier grow at the same time. Constructive synergy with the supplier. Supplier in the position to receive quick feedback regarding any potential manufacturing or design problem because of the lot size. If there is anything happening with the small lot, we inform right away the supplier to make the change, to make correction in order to meet our specification. Manufacturing in position to implement engineering change quicker because the reduced inventory level. We don't have a large quantity in process inventory, so we'll be able to adapt to any customer change or technological change or environmental change in the market. For cost decrease, well documented that just in time is to reduce the following cost. Number one, insurance associated with the storage of inventory. The more quantity you have in your facility, the more the insurance will be. The less quantity you have in your inventory, the less insurance you will be. And spoilage and theft and all of that, it will be reduced. Inventory holding costs, it will be reduced. Labor costs in storerooms and material handling costs, it will be reduced. Clerical and administrative costs, it will also decrease. Waste from the manufacturing process, it will decrease. Upselling costs, any other cost related to inventory, it will be reduced. Depreciation of handling and storage equipment, it will be reduced. So that is the major benefit for cost reduction by using just-in-time system. So just-in-time system reduce a lot of ordering costs and holding costs and many other costs, and which is reflected on the price of the final product the manufacturing produce. That is very important. Implementation of just-in-time faced some problems. What's this problem? As we mentioned before, in order to have a successful just-in-time system, you have to have what? Two major things. Trust between supplier and manufacturer. A strong commitment between supplier and manufacturer. So lack of cooperation from the supplier, it leads to the failure of just-in-time system. Lack of top management support, it leads to failure of just-in-time system. Lack of employee readiness and support, it leads to failure of just-in-time system. Lack of support from design engineering personnel, it leads to failure of just-in-time system. Lack of support from carrier company, transportation, it leads to failure of just-in-time system. Lack of communication between the supplier of and manufacturer leads to the failure of just-in-time system. So in order to have a good implementation of just-in-time system, you have to have cooperation from supplier, you have to have a strong commitment from top management, you have to have a commitment from employee, you have to have a strong design engineering personnel, commitment from them and carrier company, and a strong communication between supplier and manufacturer. So the lack of any of this, it leads to the failure of just-in-time system. As we mentioned before, there is a culture concept. And I remember during the 80s when IBM tried to implement just-in-time system. And they adapted the system, but they didn't adapt the culture. the culture concept in Japanese management, it is based on trust and strong commitment. It's based on teamwork orientation. It doesn't depend on individualistic kind of management. And that is the difference between I and we. I, it means we strongly personalize individualistic. Collectivistic means we, it means what? All different departments, all different functions in the organization participate in the system. And that's a culture concept. It's the difference between culture, American culture, and Japanese culture. It led IBM when they implemented just-in-time system. It was a total failure. Why? Because they adapted the technique, but they didn't adapt the culture. They adapted the technique, and they have the individualistic approach to run the business. In order to implement just-in-time, we have to go with the collectivistic culture. Collectivistic culture, it means the total participation of all different functions and of all different parts in the organization. We, instead of saying I, we should say we. A crucial issue to be considered in the relevance of culture in the successful implementation of just-in-time system in a country. So you, instead of adapting the system, you adapt the system and you adapt the culture associated with the system. Honda culture, for example, and Toyota culture, it focuses on group orientation activity. Not individualistic, but collectivistic, group activity, are particularly suitable to the implementation of the just-in-time production control system in that environment. So in order to have successful implementation of just-in-time system, so we should look for collectivistic or teamwork orientation in order to have a successful implementation of just-in-time. The need to have harmony in organization provide for better manufacturer-supplier relationship at Toyota and Honda, for example. And as I mentioned, it's win-win strategy, not win-lose or lose-lose. No, it's win-win strategy. Toyota win and their supplier win at the same time. Toyota grow and at the same time, their supplier grow at the same time. That is the basic issue for the success of just-in-time system. Of course, the failure of business relation between manufacturer and supplier has a strong stigma associated with it, which both manufacturer and supplier try to avoid as much as possible. And that is the language of what is the advantage we should use in order to be successful, not our difference. So we should eliminate the difference and look for the similarity between the supplier and manufacturer. And that's in order to have a win-win strategy. So we shouldn't look for our difference, but we look for our similarity. And we maximize the similarity. We talk about the positive, not talk about the negative perspective. The critical analysis of just-in-time concept, many countries, companies turn to just-in-time just to look for, because when just-in-time introduced 40, 50 years ago, it reduced costs, and most of the manufacturing in American system, they want to reduce costs. They switch it to just-in-time system. They used to have MRP, or material requirement plan, and it wasn't really so successful at the time. Therefore, when they adapted just-in-time, they use it for the sake of reducing costs. But when they eliminate the culture concept, it doesn't achieve its rule. Over the year, this company have come to realize the tremendous effort and the commitment required to make just-in-time system work smoothly. So just-in-time, it is a team work orientation. So in order to have a good implementation for just-in-time, so you have to be able to change your culture. Instead of individualistic, you have it to have it collectivistic. Instead of I, we should talk as we in order to be able to get the most advantage of just-in-time system. It takes time to change attitude, of course, of workforce, and nurture long-term relationship with the supplier. It is not short-term, it is long-term. So success of just-in-time system, it doesn't go for short-term, it goes for long-term. Long-term means in order to build the trust, you need long period of time between the supplier and the manufacturer. In order to have a strong commitment, you need to have long-term, not short-term. The transition to just-in-time has not necessarily been a smooth one for many companies in the United States, but this does not imply that switching from the pure MRP or material requirement planning system to just-in-time or hybrid system was a mistake for most companies. There is two serious drawback with MRP system. Number one, the master production schedule that drive MRP is based on estimated customer requirement and the customer change, and change frequently, especially with the speed or acceleration of technological change. So when technology change, we have to change with it. MRP system is based on slow change, not high change. Second, MRP production system utilize a push system for manufacturing goods. Just in time or Kanban system utilize pull system. So instead of push system, it is pull system. That is the major or critical analysis of the two things. Another thing, which another critical issue for just-in-time manufacturing, is the variability in product demand. Just-in-time system, it is designed for a stable demand, but stability is not really true in all different systems. We have variability. Variability demand, it can goes up, it can goes down. We can have seasonality and so on. Just-in-time system to work best when its smooth production and low inventory requirement are aimed at meeting relatively stable product demand. That's a uniform demand over the year. However, demand patterns are not stable. It goes up and down all the time for all product. In order to induce a relatively stable demand, companies using just-in-time manufacturing system often consolidate their product line, where the average is high and low, and they can smooth the production according to the variability in demand. I wish you the best of luck, and I hope this lecture, it meets your needs. And God bless Egypt, and God bless the army of Egypt and the police of Egypt, and God bless all people who are responsible for making things happen and safe for our student. I hope this video, it will be helpful for you in order to go through this critical time we face these days. I wish you all the best of luck, and God save you, and God bless you. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.